coming here and those viewing live via pay-per-view from around the world. Whirlpool.com would like to welcome you to the Amsterdam Billiard Club, located on the east side of the Big Apple in New York City, where they are proud to host the Fury World Summit of Pool, brought to you by Dragon Promotions. Let's get started. First up, from Los Angeles, California, he is a former junior champion. He is a former collegiate champion. He is currently ranked 11th in the world. Please give it up for Mad Max, Max Everly.
Yeah.
And his opponent from Atlanta, Georgia, he is sponsored by Scorpion Cues. He is the house pro at the Pool Room in Marietta, Georgia. He is a four-time player of the year, four-time champion of the world, the player of the decade, and the number one seed here. Please give it up for the Scorpion, Johnny Archer.
He's got a game face on. He's got a game face on.
Aaron went all out on that one.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Whirlpool.com production. And we're here at the Fury's World Summit of Pool Tournament. And this is held, as you can see on the screen, in the nice vicinity of the Amsterdam Billiards Club East Side. And that's located in Manhattan, New York. And I'm here. My name is Niels Feijen.
And I'm Frank Alvarez.
Yes. And Frank is a... Is he in his second season as a touring pro now, I think?
Yeah, I just started my second season.
Yeah, we met, I think, August last year.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. We've known each other
for
a year.
What was that? Richmond, right? Richmond, Virginia.
Well, it was the Peninsula Nineball Open.
Yeah.
The first UPA event.
Yeah, first UPA event we met. And you've been playing a lot of events, and you've been starting to do some work for the UPA itself,
yeah,
is that right?
Yeah, I started as the lead representative for the UPA, and that's been going well, handling PR, trying to help out the players as well, and it's good. It's a good operation, it's a good organization, we've got some good people behind it. And
yeah, it's starting to kick off.
It really is.
I like this is an event that everybody's been looking forward to, because if this one finishes off nice, then next year it'd be in Grand Central.
That's exactly right. We saw Vanderbilt Hall where it's going to be, and it'll be a good event.
Yeah, so let's look forward to that. All right, we've got the first game on the way. As you can tell, is breaking from the box in this event. And we got Max Everly here, and he's been, he really impressed me this tournament, because he lost his very first match. I think it was to Kit Delicious, Danny Bacevich.
Yeah, that's right.
And I've been seeing him every day, just playing all day long pretty much. And he had a couple of 10-10 matches, and he's been playing really intense and just fighting hard. He's been playing really good.
And then he met Danny again last night and took it back.
Yeah, he took some revenge on that. And that was a quick match, because he had him like 11-4, 11-5, I think, he hit him. So that was pretty good.
Well, Kid Delicious, Danny Bacevich, also had a great turnout.
Yeah.
You know.
He's been playing really good lately. And he plays really intense. And if you watch him sometimes when he gets into his mode, he starts shouting and yelling.
Yeah, I noticed that. I told him, hurt my ears.
Yeah, he really gets into it. I was playing Rodney yesterday, and he was so intense in his match with, I think, Johnny Archer, that he sharked Rodney, and Rodney had to go to Scott Smith to warn him, like, hey, like, take it easy a little bit. Just another match going on.
Well, Max is pretty much, he had a great break. He pretty much stopped the cue ball, but it got bumped a little, and he's been running out since then. He's on the 7, I think, here.
He's on 7.
Or is it? Yeah. Yeah, he's on the 7.
Just hit the rail. And he's come off again with a good start.
If you watch his demeanor, he's nice and smooth. Yeah. It's a great start for the first game of the day.
Yeah, there we go.
First match.
It's really good. Can't be said enough that the first game usually sets the tone for the whole match. Yeah. If you break a run out, your confidence like right there.
Oh, yeah.
Like if you miss an easy ball in the first game, you're fighting against it.
That's right. And the guy sitting down sees that you're nice and smooth and you're doing your job. And so.
And he's getting cold and you're getting warm.
Exactly.
So it's a big momentum shift.
That's one thing I appreciate about Max since I've been on tour is he's a smooth guy.
Yeah.
He's got the way he carries himself around the table, overall demeanor, he's very smooth and fluid.
Well, he just plays like he is in life, you know, just a cool guy.
He's just a really relaxed guy,
and that's how he plays. He doesn't rush into anything, he just takes his time, and he will not shoot until he's ready to shoot.
That's right.
And that's a quality asset in itself. Well, he came up dry on that break, and that's always tough with breaking from the box.
Well, I think he hit it a little harder the first break.
Yeah.
You know.
Got a little more action into his
first break. Johnny got here. Let's see a bird's eye view.
Now, Johnny's been playing great pretty much the last couple of weeks already. He just got out of the seven ball tournament. He won that, beating Thorsten Homan in the finals, and he beat Francisco Bustamante in the Bustamante in the semifinals, and he's been really playing great. I lost him last night. I was down 10-2 in no time, and I made two safety errors. I was down 10-2, and I came back 10-7, and he finally ran out of real good rack to win that match. So he's been playing a lot quicker too than he usually does, and he likes that. We had an interview last night. He said he picked up the pace a little bit, and it's really working for him. So it should be a good match.
That is a little different because Johnny Archer, you know, he usually does play a little slower. He's just very cautious, you know.
Very meticulous.
If he doesn't like the way he got down, he will definitely get back up. And he'll do it
four or five times.
You know, but that's good, though. On tour, players know that when he's doing that, he ain't going to miss.
Yeah.
You know.
He's got a little problem here. He's got to go from the 4 to the 5, but the 7's kind of in the way of coming straight in for the 5, so he's got to play a really tight position here for the 5 ball. He's got to really watch that he doesn't get behind that 7. So he should get somewhere in the line from the spot to the 5 is where he would preferably be. And, well, he got pretty close to where I said. So.
Yeah.
Now he'll just put a good stroke in this.
You know, he doesn't mind a little extra distance.
No, because he's feeling comfortable.
That angle. Yeah, exactly.
Got a little bit on the rail here, so this is no easy shot by no means. Because he's got to jack up a little bit because he's got to come back for the 7.
Yeah, that's right.
Because the 7, if he stops it, he might make the 7, but still, he doesn't want to roll forward, so he's got to jack up the cue. And every time you do that when you're close to the rail, if you put a little bit of English on it, that cue goes right off its path.
And it's important that he get out here, considering the fact that Max is already up and running.
Exactly.
At this point, it's Max 1 and Johnny. Johnny got
nice shot.
That was a great
shot.
That
was a nice shot. Okay. He'll play this in the corner and draw back to the middle diamond.
Yeah, he's moving along.
Yeah, you see his pace? He plays a lot quicker. He's real aggressive.
When you get into those finals and you start tasting that, and he's such a champion, and, he expects to win. It's tough, tough to beat a guy like that, and they expect to win.
Yeah, there's one thing about Johnny. He's won so many tournaments. He knows how to win.
Yeah, that's right.
He learned that the hard way, and he's got so much experience.
Yeah. And, you know, being my first year on tour, it's something I can appreciate. You know, you just got to break through it all.
Yeah.
You know, and you see some of these guys, you meet them, and they're just, you know, there's no real secret. They'll just tell you, you just got to break the ice.
Yeah.
You know, you just got to essentially pay your dues. And Johnny has more than done that.
Oh, yeah.
He's well-respected, and there he is, 1-1.
Yep.
Now watch Johnny's break. He's got a great break.
Yeah, he's known all over the world for his break. He's got that incredible extension, that follow through that he swears by, and he's got real good fundamentals on the break. Whoa. He always takes his time.
How do you like breaking from the spot? You all right with that?
From the box?
Yeah, from the box.
Yeah, I don't really mind because
wow,
here goes
the
nine.
This.
Whoa, that's what
There's
we're talking about.
Yeah, exactly.
They would have had a shot on a one.
You know what? That hurts the guy in the seat. Not just score wise, but nobody likes to see that. Yeah. You know?
Yeah, that hurts. And this format, we're wrecking our own balls. I don't think Johnny intentionally did anything with the balls to make the nine go, because that's only the second one I've seen so far on that table.
Yeah.
But he's just really breaking good on this table.
Now, I don't know if they headed straight for the corner or if he got knocked in. You know.
I think he went straight in. Just his own speed.
Well, let's see what happens. There's no question he'll try to do the same thing here.
Anyway, I don't really mind the break box because I've been working on it a lot. I like my own break from the box a lot. So I think it's good. The corner ball doesn't go as often as from the side. And you don't make the one as often in the side break from the box. So
especially when you got that. We got Max and Johnny here putting together that racket.
It's a little more a technical break. You've got to really have a good technique and a good square hit break from the box instead of in comparison to break from the side. It's more, sometimes you don't really have to have all that good of a break to break you good from the side row.
And you know, both Johnny and Max are actually on the UPA rules committee.
Yeah.
So they, you know, they like that. And that's exactly why they went, why the rules committee went with the break from the box, is because it's more difficult.
Yeah.
And we also got Ralph Souquet on that board, and we got Nick Varner, Charlie Williams, you know.
Now, how does that work? They just do that over the internet and do like a poll or something?
No, they sit down and discuss it. You got top players discussing what's the best, you know, what's the best format to go by, what's most difficult, you know, and that's what they came up with.
I like that. Three real safety there.
Yeah.
Not sure if he got it.
Well, I don't think he can. Max, well, I don't know.
Even if he didn't, Max still got it. He's got a cue over the two ball, so this is like an extremely difficult shot.
Yeah. And that, if he can't see it, I think it's a pretty safe kick.
Yeah. He can hit it behind, hit the short rail first, just medium speed, and like that, just let the one do the work and create distance between the cue ball and the one ball. And he's gone. He covered the our left-hand side of the one, so Johnny can't make it in the right, which is good. He can make it in his right, in the corner pocket, so.
Yeah. With the, you know, in any more on tour, the one thing you learn is that if Johnny can see it, it's dangerous.
Yeah.
You know, it's dangerous because he can figure something out. Most often they will.
This shot here is definitely going to send a message to Max.
Yeah. And you know what? Johnny will pull these off and get shape on the 2-2s right up there, right?
Yeah, all he's got to do is really make it.
Yeah.
It's one of those shots, position's natural, but he's got to jack up. Make the shot and you win this game.
But Johnny's doing his lining up.
Yeah.
Make sure that he's on that thing.
Nope.
Almost got lucky inside. He didn't quite leave a hanger for the lead, but he's not happy with that.
No, you can see his shake comes out. He'll just float the cue ball. This is also a natural position. Just make the ball. Cue ball do the rest.
Yeah.
And critical here is that the four ball's on the left. And three balls. Oh, that's a seven ball. So,
yeah, I thought the seven ball was more in the way, but it wasn't. And he put it right there in that corner without a problem.
Okay. I thought that was the three ball. It's a little hard to see from our screen sometimes. Just draw this back to where he pretty much is right now.
Now, if you take a little funny behind the scenes fact is, if you take a look at Max's bridge, which is a pretty common bridge on tour,
uh-huh.
It looks an awful lot like the logo. I'll give you a guess as to who actually did the UPA logo. You know, Max is an artist.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he's a great artist. he's the one that put the logo together. So take a close look at the UPA logo and you'll see a pretty standard bridge from yours truly, Max Evans.
That he he had himself in the mirror, took a picture, and just did it from there.
But he is a good artist. So he used
good guy. Solid player.
Yes, he is. You know, and he always moves the same.
Same rhythm.
Yeah,
no matter how good you're playing, you're going to have a hard time with him. Because he pretty much dictates the speed of the match.
Oh, you're right. By the speed of the pace. And he won't let his opponent dictate it. He just goes about his way. And that's very important in a match, that you don't play the other guy's game.
Exactly.
You know? It
takes a lot of experience to be able to do that. You know, like if you play guys like Strickland or Rodney Morris, like the fast guns, and it's really easy to get sucked in that speed and make a couple of first errors, and then it's boom, the match is over.
You're right, because they make it look so easy, so you almost think that's the way it's supposed to be sometimes.
Exactly.
You know, and you think if you take too long, take longer than that, there's something wrong, but you just got to make sure you play your speed.
You see that the players are racking the two right underneath the one. What happens is the two balls under the one usually travel up table, and in this instance, break from the box, the one ball usually also ends up table.
Yeah, so in fact, you'll even see the 1, 2, and three all up front.
Yeah.
Here
you see the one and the two going up table. Mm-hmm. Now, if he would have had a good shot in the one, the percentages are that you have an easy starter.
Yeah.
Like the 1, 2 are right there, so you can dominate the layout.
And you'll even have some guys who are breaking so well, they'll put a little draw on that cue ball because they know that that one and that cue are going to be on the same side of
you'll
the table.
You'll see Jose Perica do that.
Yeah, I've watched Bustamante here do that.
Mm-hmm. He's just going to stick it behind it too. I like that shot there. Wow.
That was good. Real close to that too.
He left him a one railer though. Johnny can just hit the side rail here. I think he's got to hit this with some speed.
You know, and for those watching and those who study these tapes, that's what you want to do is close up that distance between the blocking ball and that cue, because it really limits what you can do to kick out of there.
Yeah.
But it's important not to try that so hard that you let that cue ball sneak out. You know, just make sure you get it back there somewhere.
I think Johnny got a little lucky there because he missed the hit straight on. He hit it on the backside and he still created a lot of distance. So he's got to be feeling really happy with that shot right there.
Max is looking to pocket this one, trying to see what's going to happen with the cue. Go around, he'll miss that 8.
I kind of like a safety here too. I can't really see the angle from up the table, but I like a safety too, sending the one ball to the left, our left, and the cue ball up by the 7.
Can't tell if it's going for it or safe.
He might be shooting.
Oh no, he's definitely
like
playing
that.
Safe.
He hit a little too
hard.
He didn't
like what he saw when he measured up and he went for the safe. I think Johnny can see that one.
I wonder if Johnny can just hit the right side of the one and put him behind the 2-5 again. Or he's got to jack up and send the cue ball 2 rails zigzag across the table, like long rail, and behind the 2-5. And then put the cue ball under the, maybe under the 7 if he's cueing high. Wow.
Hit
the 6. Well, at least he got the distance, but he won't be too happy with hitting the 6.
Now, what do you like here? Well, I don't know if he can he can go on either side of that one ball. He can go left to it or right up.
Might have to spin this with a lot of left English and leave like a parallel safety, like the one on the middle diamond and the cue ball on the middle diamond, hooked with the 2-5. This is a hard shot. You could go for it, like cut it in and send the cue ball 2 rails back to the 2, but that's you gotta be feeling awful good. You could actually kick at it too.
Yeah,
he hit it a little hard again, but that was the shot, I think. Now Johnny's got to go for this bank, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
If he's got a little angle, he can send the cue ball 2 rails under the 2 ball and come pretty much to the same spot that where he is now, if he's got that angle. Otherwise, he's got to He's got the eye to straight draw back or hit it with follow and hit it off the rail and back for the two. So he's got a lot of options. It's pretty much all depends on how much angle he has on this shot. There you go.
And he puts
coming
the two right back where he shot it from.
That's a nice shot.
Wow. That's a great shot.
He's playing with a lot of confidence, Johnny. And
again, that was the safe wasn't as good as Max wanted it.
Yeah. Sold out. And for you people that didn't know that, we got little Johnny Jr. on the way.
That's right.
How many months?
That's a good question. I just asked him and I forgot.
Think like 4 months?
Yeah, I mean, it's
4 or 5 months probably.
And in fact, I think there's a couple names we're throwing out there. And I don't remember if Johnny was one of them. It might be.
If he was.
I don't remember. Yeah, I don't remember. But yeah, congratulations to Johnny and his wife.
What he's looking at is playing position under the six. He'll go three rails, hit the short rail last. One, two, and the third. And he got on the 50-yard line.
Yeah.
This is where you not want to be, because now you can shoot in the left pocket or the right pocket. And this is a hard shot here.
Well, if he goes for the left pocket, it looks like that cue will be hit that rail here and come up for the seven pretty naturally.
And if he would miss it, he'd be hooked by the seven.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
So I would definitely go for the other pocket here. But not him. I kind of like the other way better because it wasn't an easy shot. And if you get close to the seven, in case you miss it, you're hooked by the seven. So, but that just shows you how much confidence he has right now, because he didn't ponder over there too long like
right.
he used to. He just pretty much took 10 seconds and then boom. He's making short work of this. He's going to take the lead here. That's a nice out.
3-2, Johnny.
3-2, Johnny.
Overall, this has been a great event. It went relatively smooth.
Yeah.
And we definitely look forward to next year. You're going to come next year, aren't you?
I hope so, yeah. I want to come again. I'll be playing a bunch of UPA events next year, probably.
You were joking around with Johnny and playing in here in New York. We told him he's playing faster. It must be that New York phase. You take a cab here, you start moving different, you know?
Yeah. I hear that from a lot of Americans, like New York, man. It's a totally different world. It's so hectic and fast-paced. But for me, like, I'm from Holland, and Holland's like in the top five of highest populated countries in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And if you go to Amsterdam, it's the same thing.
Really?
It's like madhouse.
Yeah, wow.
And The Hague is not where I live. It's not that bad, but I mean, I'm pretty much used to this, so.
And you know, that's an important factor, being able to get used to your environment when you travel on the road so much. You know, it really is. People don't realize there's so much going on outside the table. That's a great thing.
That is textbook there for the cue ball.
Yeah, exactly.
Now that right here is what I experienced in a lot of matches too. That one ball, it travels towards that side rail, like in the middle of the side rail a lot. If you break from
Did it hit before the side pocket or after the side pocket?
I think it hit after the side pocket, and it just travels natural pace towards that rail. So we have to start figuring out something where you either hit it a little bit off center and let the cue ball go towards that bulk area, because otherwise you're not going to get a shot.
Yeah, and you know, and this might be a situation where you actually may want to draw the cue ball back a little because of that.
If you can't
stop that one ball.
And you'll see Jose Perica doing that in the upcoming match. He'll cut break that ball and just draw it back towards the ball carrier. And he gets a lot of opportunities that way.
That's right. And you know, that's an important note when you're sitting on the seat, when you're sitting in the chair watching your opponent. Watch the break.
Yeah.
You know, let him be kind of it's kind of like somebody putting before you do. You get to see the lie, you know.
You get to go to school.
you get to, you know, that way you can be actively
involved.
Exactly.
He's got a couple of options here. If he wants to be real aggressive, he could play the 7 or the 5, really. He's looking at the 7 as a billiard, I think. But the thing is that one ball is going to go in between the 9 and the 2s we see it on the screen. And then what is it going to do? You know, it's going to hit the 2. You have no clue where the one ball is really going to end up. So that's why he's pondering now. He could play safety, but then he can't really hit it on the left-hand side of the 1 because he's going to sell out. Right. His cue ball is going to go to the right-hand pocket. And he can't really hit it on the right. He couldn't really... Yeah, I think he could hit it on the right and let the 1 ball hit the 5 ball and let the cue ball go in between the 8 and 9 and get behind the 2. That would be a good shot.
Maybe he's afraid that the 1 will actually make the 5. Then you're in trouble.
No, he can't get that speed on there. I don't think so. I think he's going all out for 7. I like that shot where he stops the 1 with the 5 ball. You got to get a little lucky here. He did. That was a nice shot.
Well, there you go.
Sometimes you got to trust the luck.
Yeah, and you know what? That's as far as Johnny's concerned. You got to run out from here, right? You got the 1, the 2, and is the 2 right next to that? Is that the
1? Yeah, that's the 2. Yeah, this is a connected dots here.
That shot, taking that risk, you know, doing what he did, could, you know, that was the game winner.
Yeah, he got rewarded.
He gets out. Johnny's shooting like a champion.
He's a little funny here. He can't really draw it back because he's going to flirt with the 9. He might get stuck behind the 9 or something. He can't really draw it to the other side real because the 6 is going to block him. So he's got to find a path to where he's safe and he's got the angle to go to the 5. So he's thinking about just slow roll spinning it in. Like that, with a little drag stroke, and now just take a little more of a cut on the 4. Yeah. But this is no problem, really. It'll just hit the short rail on the long rail and then get an angle on the 5. And go 2 rails to the 6.
Yeah. And of course, we say it's no problem. We're sitting here watching.
Exactly.
You know, we don't got the nerves going on. And
our heartbeat's like really relaxed. Oh, he's going to the corner. Wow.
And
he must have had a lot of more. Wow.
That's what happens.
Hostile.
You know, you can't.
He had a lot more angle than we thought. I thought he could just slide, spin that ball in.
Wow.
But how can he go for the corner? Because he was almost straight in. He had to like force an angle. That was weird there.
I don't. You know, we spoke too soon. Anything can happen.
Yeah, we jinxed him.
You know.
Max got to come with a good stroke on this shot. If he's got enough angle, the shot I like personally, if he had a little more angle, is like hit the short rail, long rail, and then back to the long rail where he is now, and then come short on the 5. I really, you know, like power stroke shot, but he doesn't have that angle. He'll just go in between the long rail and the side pocket, I think. Oh, he is playing for that shot. See what I mean?
He hit that ball hard.
I mean, that cue ball does all the work. It's a lovely shot. He just created most of the angle, too.
Wow.
He's going to draw this out with low right. Play just before the side pocket.
Now, what about just drifting it down for the other pocket?
I was thinking about that too, but he looked at he was pointing his finger by the right-hand side, but he must have not liked that because he's playing just one rail.
But you know, it's good that he checks like that as opposed to just making a decision. I think he came pretty natural for the 8 here.
Yeah. Pretty safe ways, just play for a side pocket. You don't have to like slow roll it. You can let your stroke out a little bit. There we go, side pocket. Got on the wrong side of the 8, however, so he's got to send the cue ball a couple of rails. It's pretty much just 3 rails out to the center of the table and come for the 9. Pretty standard shot. A little soft. Ooh, wow.
Yeah.
It was a pretty standard shot, but there's got to be some tension in the area, center court, I think. Nice shot there.
Nice shot. has the score 3-3.
3-3. And for all you pool fanatics out there, there's you can order DVDs also on the website. Behind me, you see the DVDs laying out there, and we got some matches with Troy Frank versus Corey Duhl, myself, Niels Vijf versus Corey Duhl. Actually, we got Mika and Corey Duhl, and those are really good matches we played about a year ago in the King of the Hill tournament in Canton, Ohio. And there's some good study material on that, on those DVDs. So if you're interested in that, just browse around at the worldpool.com site and get a couple.
Definitely. Check it out. That's one of the things I've had to do, is make sure I watch all you guys closely and see why you think the way you think. And
yeah, I did a lot of my own progress. I got that from a lot of tapes.
Yeah. You know, when your mind works and you don't even know it.
Yeah.
So watching those, you know, it's good.
You pick up the patterns subconsciously a lot of times.
And people don't realize that, but it's true.
And just listening to the commentary of the guys.
Now, on that break there, he was a little... cue ball sent a little right.
He's got a lot of balls up table, which means he had a pretty square hit, though.
Maybe the... I don't know if the cue ball went there or if it banged.
From this angle, we can't really see if the one passes the five. Ooh, that's really close. Now, Efren probably played the billiard. Anyway, he looks like he's going for it. It's a tough shot. Ooh, oh. He had like half a pocket there. But Johnny's gonna play good safety here. He'll probably stick him with the cue ball right under that five now.
Yeah. Opting, of course, to have the cue ball tied up, send one the other way, or... lots of times you see guys make the mistake of sending the one to the open area, the cue to the open area. If you want that cue ball tied up just like that.
That's good. He's stuck on the high ball too.
He's making out with that five, that's for sure.
This has been a good play match so far. It's been a lot of interesting shots.
I've only seen, that four ball by John last rack. He had a tough shot.
Tough shot in the four?
A couple matches before, a couple games before.
Max just missed that one ball.
Calling for a ref here to walk.
Yeah, they want to just make sure that he doesn't graze the five ball, I think.
Yeah, they're calling. Scott Smith will be here.
Our tournament director, Scott. Coming in picture for the
Scott show. Does a great job.
Yeah. Important here, he's got to hit this with some speed, because if he is going to hit it, he's got to create distance between the one and the cue ball. That's really important. You got to take a chance. If you hit this soft, you can't win.
Yeah, you have to try and make something happen sometimes. That's kind of your only option.
Johnny gets ball in hand, and this could be one of those moments in the match where you see a guy just run away.
Yeah.
Because he's up, it's 3-3, and this is a great opportunity to seize the moment.
We won't jinx him this time.
Well, still, because I think the 6 doesn't pass the 8 from the other angle, but from that angle it looked like it went. Yeah, this is still not easy. It's got to go from the 6 to the 7, first from the 5 to the 6, then the 6 to the 7, and then from the 8 to the 9, so this is still a tough layout. If the 6 doesn't pass the 8...
Yeah, that's what I can't see. I can't see if he gets past
the... He's got to play underneath the 6, But the most important thing is he needs an angle. Now that a six must pass the eight. That makes it a lot easier. Here he needs an angle. Wes, you think he's playing the combo?
No, I don't think so. I just don't think he likes being straight on it like that.
I don't like this.
Now he's got a decision to make here.
Man, he's got to like pop this out. He's playing a combo now.
Yeah. Because
he's got no angle. All he can do is like pretty much just stop it or draw it or something.
Yeah, I don't think you want to draw for that. Well, I don't know. Well, let me see.
He's playing the combo because then.
Wow.
Ooh.
Wow. I thought he nailed that.
Oh, man.
He thought he nailed it too.
He can't believe it?
Yeah, he's wondering how that happened.
He can't believe it. That's deep. That's deep. Now, Max got to watch that he doesn't make both of them. What he should do for all the players, this is pretty interesting. Don't put all your eggs in playing position on the six, because here, if that six drops and you play position for the same side,
wow.
Where the,
right.
You know
that's
what I mean? You got to play position
good.
Actually
good
for
call.
The seven ball. Because if you make them both, then at least you have the seven.
That's good. And had he not made the six, it was pretty, it'd pretty much be a hanger.
Yeah, it's still in the hole, so then you go from there. Boom. Now all of a sudden the momentum is switched over to Max's side. Yeah, that was not an easy out, like you said.
Max Eberle 4, Johnny Archer 3. We're at the Fury World Summer of Pool. Niels Fain and myself, Frank Alvarez.
Yeah, I've been having a good time here all week. I drove in last Sunday night, so I've been here a good week.
How long have you been in the States this time?
Like almost a month, I think.
Really?
I was here since the U.S. Open, and I played five tournaments in a month. And I've been having a lot of fun. I played four nine-ball tournaments and actually a straight-ball tournament last week in New Jersey, which was really cool, too. I didn't expect to go there. I just love it to play like with all these guys, you know. In Europe, it's one thing, but we just don't have enough tournaments where you compete against each other.
Right.
If you go to the States, there's so many tournaments, and even the little tournaments like the Joss Tour, the Viking Tour, you still get to play with like Jose Parrico, Dan Bacevich, and it just keeps you sharp, you know. And
because between the major events, they go off to events that have good turnout, and it's good to get that seasoning.
Yeah, for all you aspiring pool players that live in the States, I would definitely advise you to go visit a lot of those tours. Because you learn to play under heat, no pressure, and you get a lot of good experience from that. And you watch the good guys even play in those tournaments. Nice shot there, nice shot. But the reason he didn't play it in the side is because he had to come back for that three ball. Had he played in the side, he'd have to go all the way up table, back to the center of the table. This way, if he makes it in the corner, position's automatic.
He drifts up for the five. Looking to draw back for the six.
Important there, too, is that you stay on the left side of straight in and on the previous screen. Get that in a minute, because here, if he would run a little bit further, he's got to mess with the eight. Now he'll just draw it back to the safe area of the table where there's no balls. I always look for man, there's got to be a little bit of tension there. I'm telling you,
yeah,
these guys,
you know,
go ahead.
He didn't put as much draw on there as I thought he would, or.
I noticed that from experience myself. You know, when you play that Saturday night and you play a lot of matches, and then you step in the arena on the Sunday, and it takes you a minute to warm up. And, oh, he got awfully close.
Yeah.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, neither player's walking away with this so far.
Wow.
It's kind of like drawed a little bit.
Yeah.
That was a bit shot.
Nice and smooth.
Back in position.
Doesn't stress himself out.
No.
Just.
Broke her on that rack, right?
So, yeah, he did. He did.
Yeah, this is the moment.
After that combo.
Combo missed with Johnny. Yeah, you're hearing that? This is the moment in the match where you want to blow it open. You want to, like, make it 8-3 if you can right now. You know, it doesn't have to be with runouts, but just make balls in the break, hook them, run out, break, run out, you know? Get it to where you put a lot of pressure on the other guy and you're almost at the finish line.
That's right.
So important.
That's right. They must be having trouble with one of the balls or a gap in there or something.
Yeah.
This is, I think, the third time.
That's happened.
Both come up and view the rack.
There you see the two again directly under the one.
One, two, three.
Now, if you would be racking for the other guy, it would be a different story.
Yeah, you'd be definitely putting the two in the back somewhere.
Yeah, it stays on
there. What I like to do is watch what that two does while he's breaking.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'll put it in the very back. And if it, you know, if it's not doing what I like, I'll switch
it around. Good break again. Johnny's disgusted with that. Because I don't know if Max is cut breaking them a little bit intentionally or not, but
well,
it's
notice
working
the,
out.
Well, see, yeah, I wasn't paying attention to the cue. I don't know if they got knocked back there, but notice that the cue and the one are in the same side of the table this time. I wish I was paying attention to what the one, how the one actually got there. Because, as we'd mentioned before, it was drifting towards the middle. This time it's towards that corner.
He's looking three balls ahead right now. Actually, that's the fourth ball ahead that he's looking at, the five ball. He's looking from which angle he can best make it and get position on the six. And the last thing he looked at is probably the best. Yeah. He misses make that. What I like here, personally, is get above the three with my cue ball.
Here we
are. Here's Brunswick, the tables that we play on. Always the best tables, in my opinion, Brunswick's.
Yeah, they definitely are a good table. Beautiful tables.
I can't really see the angle, but he's lining up. He's going for the straight in angle on the five. So hit just before the side and try and come straight in on the five.
You don't think he's shooting for that gap lead, no?
Yeah, he is.
Look at this.
I don't like that at all. He might have gotten away with it, but didn't he just play for the angle, like put
that's
the cue ball next to the six, like
that's
on the right
question,
side of the six.
Yeah. That would seem to be the safe thing to do.
And he gets two real shape on the six. Yeah, if he makes it, he travels to the six. I can't believe it. Unless he like played it for right where he is now, but of course for us it's easy over here.
Well, yeah, and sometimes they have a hard time seeing how much room he has there.
Yeah. Doesn't look like he can make it though. He would have already gotten down and shot it.
Well,
he's got to play safe. If he's got to play safe, what I like is put the 5 under the 7-9 and just send the cue all the way up table. Create as much distance as I can and even hopefully put him like on the Brunswick plate.
Now, so you're saying go to the left of the five?
Yeah.
If he can do that, then why not cut it?
Because he might not have that much of a cut at it.
Oh, I see.
What I'm saying is like hit a half ball and just with a lot of English, get the cue ball travels on.
What is he? I don't know what he's thinking of.
He might be thinking of a bank. This is an important moment too in the match.
Well, if you bank it, you want to hit it at a good speed so that if you do miss, it comes off that rail. Mm-hmm. Right?
He can't make up his mind. Yeah, what you're saying is...
if he goes for the bank, the five in the corner...
It doesn't hang up.
Right.
At least it comes back to the short rail. He's playing under the seventh cue ball. Yeah. Well, nice shot. Good recovery. A lot of one reel kick shots this match. This is another one. He's got to go one reel and again hit it with some speed. And you got to get a little lucky in this shot. All you can do is hit it. One reelers are so hard to judge if they're in the middle of the table, like what side you're going to hit. You got to just hit it with a firm stroke and hope good things are going to happen. And that, he got robbed there. Wow. Scratched. That didn't have to happen. I go crazy when that happens. I'm telling you, man. That's hard to fake.
That's when you start talking to yourself.
Yeah. You start having the devil and the angel conversation.
Yeah, exactly.
You're right.
And then you tell yourself you're not supposed to be talking to yourself.
You develop three personalities right there. Oh, man. All right. Max got rewarded for that safety. Oh, look at Johnny. He's not having a good time at all. Ooh. He's not having fun. Draw this to the center of the table. And again, you know, this angle, I really like for this angle that much. He's got to draw back to the side rail and come all the way back to the center of the table. He needs a good stroke on this, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. He's got to put a good stroke on this. Max has that, though. That's a good stroke. Boom. Nice
shot.
Nice shot.
There it is.
Sure. All right, this is for 6-3. And that's a really big game. Johnny's thinking, you know, if I hit the five ball and get lucky, it might have been 5-4. You know? Yeah. 6-3.
6-3, Max Eberle over Johnny Archer. And here's that trying to sneak away you were talking about, especially with that unlucky kick.
Yeah. Now we get a chance to see what Max is doing on the break that's working so good for him.
Some of the crowd there early.
Yeah.
Pretty early there. We had some people late.
New York's got a really cool crowd. A lot of people know their stuff, you know?
Yeah, they do. Well, you have Team Amsterdam here and Amsterdam Billiards.
They really applaud for all the good shots, and it's a really lot of fun to play out here, I'll tell you.
They have a chance to see some good players so they know the game.
Yeah. They'll tell you and they'll show their appreciation, you know? It's really cool if you're a pro and get applauded for a cool shot.
Yeah. Look at that. Look at that cue ball. Oh, look at this. Look at the cue. Five ball comes around, knocks the cue ball away from the one.
Otherwise, the safety would have been a lot easier. Johnny hasn't had a lot to shoot last a couple of games. Missed that combination and he had one kick on the five. That was it. And he's in trouble here.
That's so brutal. You stop that cue ball perfect, you know, on a dime and ball kind of drifts over.
Boink.
I think he's banking at this.
Nope.
I don't think he could have banked that 7 there.
No, that 7 was in the way. So the way he was lining up, he was lining up pretty aggressively.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
And the 2 was there on the left. I thought he was going for the bank. Excuse my bad call, but we can't really see all the angles sometimes.
What do you like here? I don't know how much of that one he can see. I know he can see some of it. The question is, can he come to our left side of it?
If he can, I gotta go for it. Myself, I like to go for shots. I like to take stuff from my own hands. But because you can't really play good safety, because if you gotta play safe, you gotta hit the one pretty full, and the 7's right there. You know what I mean?
Well, what about setting the one up close to this? What is that, the 7 there? And sending the cue ball
all the
way
to the 5 or what? He's got here, that's what I'm...
Wow.
That was the danger at that 7. You never know exactly what was going to happen. No, he didn't get away with it that time. Now, if the 2 passes the 8, Johnny just focuses on making this 1. However, he's going to run into this 5 ball. And that may cause a problem later in the rack, because if he puts the 5 on the rail, the 4 ball's on the same rail. So he's got a tough layout. What he would like to do is make the 1 and the 5 inside, or put the 5 in front of the side. There you go. All right, I made a little better call there.
I do believe that 2 passes.
Yeah, it passes. He's got to put a good, pure stroke on this. He's just getting the draw all the way back to the line. Huh? Wow.
He's not happy with that. But I think he'll be all right.
Sometimes it's so hard to see that the ball passes the 4.
You can tell by the expression on his face.
He ain't happy. He's got to kill this, or if he has more angle than we see, he's got to pound it back and forth. He hit that pretty good. Now just come 2 rails. Try and come straight in on the 6 for the side, the right-hand side pocket. That's what I like to do personally. Of course, he's going, I don't really know what he played there. If he played for that corner pocket or for the side pocket. Worked out pretty good.
Yeah,
that
was a good shot.
Yeah, that was a nice one. So if Johnny runs out here, he's back in the match, 6-4. Desperately needs to get his break working.
Oh, Dwarf's going to use a little... Oh.
Yeah, he's got that extension with him.
You use those?
No. I don't, really.
Johnny's tall. So you know what's out there. He's thinking about using extension. But he does fly.
Okay.
He's on this 1 here.
Okay, I just got informed that we're having some technical problems. So bear with us.
They're on top of it.
Yeah, our technical staff is working hard on it.
We apologize for any.
I don't know if you guys have a screen or not. Anyway, Johnny's on the 2 ball now. And trying to bring this match back to 6-5. Played a nice shot there.
Charleston back and 4 on the side.
4 on the side, yeah. Just play this to the center of the table, and then it's a stop shot on the 5, stop shot on the 6, or draw it back a little on the 6. This is prime position. 7 in the left corner, 8 in the side. Follow for the 9. He should be out here within 30 seconds, I think.
Coming back from the break, that's good. The break was good. You know, comes back, he nails down.
You're pumped up. Got a little angle. Nice shot.
He comes back with his game face on.
Well, it's not going to be 30 seconds, however.
Look at Max. He's composed, man.
Does Max do anything like yoga or meditation?
Max does. He's a pretty spiritual guy, really.
Yeah. Because I read in the Inside Pool, was it, or Billy Digest? Mm-hmm. He was like blocking out the ego, that's his goal, you know, playing. He wants to eliminate that. That's pretty interesting.
Yeah, it is. And he's a real, he eats real healthy.
Okay.
Real healthy.
Well, he eats real healthy, but he's been known for as a party animal, too. You know what I mean? So he...
oh, wow. You know, he got all work and no play.
You got to compensate a little. With how Max fun, guys. All right. Johnny making it 6-5 here. It's been a good match so far.
Let's see if they have to mess with us. If they didn't have to mess with the rack last night, did they? Remember, they've been tapping the balls. They didn't have to do that last one.
No.
Last game.
I had a lot of trouble rocking them, though, but like after two games, I found a spot where they froze automatically, so probably today. Sometimes it's the humidity that affects it, or...
Well, see, and that's one thing, guys, you know, here comes Max. And that's one thing that's important, is to see what you can do with the rack.
Mm-hmm.
Because if another guy's racking, you know what you can expect from it,
right.
You know. So you know, the first time you jump on a table and you rack, you're almost doing a fact-finding mission, you know, as to what's going on, what's it capable of.
True. And Johnny was stuck 4-0 against Charlie Williams last night, and he won that match 11-5. And he ran, I think, 4 racks or 5 racks, and then I played him. I had him 2-0. Next thing I know, I was stuck 10-2, and I think he ran like 4 and another 2 or 3 on me. He had like in 2 innings, he ran like 7 games.
Let's watch where this one goes. I'm interested in seeing what happens.
He's got to go straight to this corner. Whoa. Oh, 7 balls going to go on his way. He's got no shot. He's got a duck.
Well, what's he looking to do here? Is he going to maybe draw that cue ball back to where it is? Maybe, or is that 2 in the way?
I think
for
2 is
one?
In the way. I like a parallel safety between the 2. I like to put him behind the 2 and the 1 ball behind the 2 also. He's thinking about just putting him behind the 7, send the cue ball in between the side rail and the 8. The cue ball behind that, what is that? 4 ball. That shot. Ooh. I don't know if he left him a window.
Puts the one just about on the rail. Max is checking it out there. This is important. This is a big shot here because Johnny's
really
coming back. I think he came back the last two games. Was it 6-3?
It was 6-3. This is a real important kick. If he hits that right side of the 1, he's got a really big chance to make this, because he can even make it real first. He can slice it in. I really just focus on these kicks, like hit that area on the, like that area next to the 1 ball.
Right.
Like an inch to the right of the 1. If I'm in that area, I can make it real first or slice it in, as opposed to just hitting it full in the face. He doesn't like it. He's jacking up. He's jumping.
He's jumping.
Wow. He got away with it.
Is Johnny liking the bank here?
Yeah, he's got to go for this bank. Johnny banks good.
Yeah, he did.
Position's critical, though. Normally, you just like to swing at it with left angles, you know, and send it out 3 rails. However, the 6 is pretty much in the way. So then,
you got a great position too, and it takes your mind off the bank a little bit. Makes the bank a little bit harder because now he's got to like, let me learn something here because now I bank pretty good, but I'm no expert at it. Here he's got a wow. He just slowed. I like that shot. I learned something there.
Yeah.
He just banked it with speed, drew it out two rails, and left him a little longer under the two. Now myself, I would have probably had I looked at it at the table, maybe go three rails with just a little bit of topspin and come in between the 6-9, which of course is a wrong shot after I saw this one.
Speaking of banks and speaking of Danny Harriman, that's a bankable champion there.
Yeah, he won the event in Louisville, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Bankable tournament. Did he go too far in that shot? Oh, I think he can make it. He can cheat the pocket a little bit, yeah. Whoa. 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 This is getting, it's getting pretty nerve-wracking. Got to slice this in and a lot of English.
He's treated like a drawer.
Nice shot. What you do here, just follow it out two rails. I like to hit the rail just before the side, like a diamond before the side pocket, and that carries me straight towards the seven, like that. You automatically got a good angle to go to the eight. Just follow this out one rail. See, going two rails, he's drawing it two rails. Let a stroke out. And here, I like the same shot here, just two rails. I really like that. Come just before the side, and then that carries you towards the nine. He might be going one reel. No, he's going, huh? He went two reels the other way. Nothing wrong with that. There's a lot of personal preferences in those kinds of shots.
And, you know, what you're feeling like, how good you're feeling.
Yeah.
Here we go, 6-6, right?
6-6.
Johnny comes back three games to tie it up. 6-6. We're going to race to 11.
Yep.
The finals will be a race to 13.
One race to 13. There's our table manufacturer, Brunswick, again. The best table there is, in my book.
It can't be the same ball. It keeps on.
Yeah, the more they're going to tap it, the harder it's going to get. Like the freeze.
Yeah, once you start tapping, you know, depending on what's happening, you can't really see. I don't get that. Most guys cringe when you start tapping stuff, you know. But at least they're in cahoots with one another. They're both agreeing with how they're dealing with this rack.
Yeah, they're both professionals, you know. Both gentlemen.
Yeah.
I did a lot of studying when I was younger on Johnny's break. And I imitated it for a long time, like the extension. But then one day my cue slid out of my hand.
Really?
Wow. That happened like twice or something. It slid out of my hand and it went all the way across the table and I lost my heart to like let it go. To like let it go all the way in the air. And then
you lost your heart?
Yeah, I lost my heart to do it, you know, because you get scared from slitting your
Yeah,
he goes so far on that. I pretty much created my own style of breaking now.
Well, you know, and that's important. You see somebody do something, you try it,
yeah.
And then next thing you know, you do it just a little different. But there's a little bit of Johnny in there somewhere, right?
Yeah.
Because you got a powerful break.
Yeah,
a lot of these guys, a lot of these top players, they just have monster breaks.
Harriman, Archer, Bustamante.
Williams,
Holman. Myself.
Suke, I like
Suke's
break.
Very solid.
So smooth.
Yep. Workman's got a good break. out here has got a little bit of work to do. He's on the wrong side of it too. That's a pretty tricky little shot here. I don't think he's got the angle to just come with inside one rail towards the four, so he's looking maybe come up in between the 6-9, which is very risky. He might be just thinking of playing a combination because it's so risky to go in between those balls. I like the combination pretty much.
Yeah, the balls are close together.
Because at least you give yourself a chance, you know, if you hit the 9 or the 6.
Well, that, you don't have to go messing around with that cue ball and trying to bring it around.
Here, just one shot now, and he should be out.
Now, is he going to draw this cue ball a little? To make sure that...
it makes the shot a little more pure. If you shoot combinations, I like to just shoot them like center ball, like stun shot.
Yeah.
Because that's, for me personally, that's the most... right now, Johnny made that. He made the combination. We're back on track. He got perfect shape on the 5.
Oh yeah, he hit those.
He'll play for center table here. And, this is elementary stuff. Draw back to the center of the table. Here we go. And you gotta love the spirit that's. Lives in this guy, man. He just never gives up, Johnny Archer. That's why he's a 4-time world champion. I mean, he fights till the last shot. And that's a really good point to watch as you're studying pool. The fight and the spirit that these guys have under the pressure, you know. Because everybody has moments where he feels like he can't win the match.
That's
but
right,
you just gotta wait for that one chance and then just play with the ability that you have.
That even if he's 7-6 Johnny Archer.
And it was 6-3.
That's right. Comes back for Max.
And that would be interesting to see if Max, when Max gets a chance, how he's gonna stand up to it. Because he's been losing the last couple of games. Really, I still learn a lot from watching like these champions, you know, the world champions and the U.S. Open champions.
We are in Amsterdam, Booth, New York City. It's a great place. It's the first time I've been here.
Yeah, me too.
You have a very good staff, good crew.
Yep. And if you're a ping pong fanatic, you can have a ball here too.
That's right.
Normally they have 3 ping pong tables. Ooh, he squatted them balls. However, no shot. Now here we see how Max is gonna rise to the occasion.
That's what he's been doing for the last 4 games here.
He's got a, like an open table. He has to take advantage of this one. I got a weird feeling that it's gonna be hill. I don't know. Since they're both playing good, they're fighting hard. Go all the way. Important here to get a good angle on the 3. That sets up the whole rack.
Did you get a nudge that 8 or is he all right?
Yeah, that's
there?
What I was thinking. Personally, I would have done anything to stay on the other side of the 3, because I don't want to mess with that 8 at all. You don't know how fast that cue ball is going to come off the 8 towards the 4. You might leave yourself long in.
And you just might put that 8 too close to that 5 or in, you know.
Yeah, exactly. You're creating something that you didn't want to create.
That you didn't have to deal with.
That's what I mean. You don't know what speed that's going to come off that ball. You're just guessing for a shot. I mean,
see, now I thought he was going to draw that and try to come on this, try to hit the 8 on this side.
I don't think he had the angle for that. To hit the higher side of the 8, you mean?
Yeah.
Like the upper side and slide back towards the 4? Like, he couldn't get that. Now he's got a way tougher shot than if he would have been in the center of the table. maybe hit the point. Wow. Here, that's what I mean.
And that's what it was. It was the shot back on the three.
Yeah, that was the shot on the two.
Yeah, you're right. Because the
shot
angle
on the two sets the up the whole the rack.
Excuse me, that's right.
Now that's not like that's like Max is a bad player or anything, but that's just a moment in the match that might really cost him. Max a great player.
Now Johnny Denny knows to take advantage of this because the momentum has seemed to have gone the other way here. Definitely.
Now this is still our shot. Max has got to be kicking himself out. I know. This is not easy, but no, it is.
Wow.
There you go. Wow.
Yeah,
nice shot. That was a big shot.
Yep.
That was a big shot.
That might just be the turning point in the whole match. That one three to the four ball by Max. Make quick work of this. Pulling this in.
He's shooting this.
I personally like to draw it out. Because sometimes if you shoot with high, you might get friction or something weird. If you draw that ball, there's nothing going to happen. It's personal preference.
It really is. Lots of times people ask, what's the right shot? You know, there could be two or three.
Yeah, there could be three ways. You know? What you feel most comfortable with.
The right shot is what you feel like you know you're going to make.
Yeah.
You know? And that's why it's hard sometimes to explain or even to learn, because pool in some areas can be such a feel thing. It's not, it's how you feel. You have to feel right, you know, and how do you teach that, you know?
Exactly.
You know the basics, what your options are. That's important. That's a mental thing. That's a knowledge.
Knowledge.
But sometimes when it comes to a right shot, there could be a few options, and it really does boil down to how you feel about it, how safe you want to be.
How much confidence you have at that moment.
What the score is, perhaps.
The score is. Sometimes who you're playing. If you know strengths and weaknesses of your opponent, like in push-outs, you have to take that in consideration. All right, 8-6. Oh, that 7 stopped the cue ball right there. That would have gone straight to the corner.
Oh, what do you think? You think Johnny is
he going to bank it?
He comes. It'll come back around those.
He's looking for your
rails for the two. So that cue ball will be pretty natural for the two there. See that?
I don't know. He,
come back around.
He's got a jack up to come all the way to do that. He was looking at if it was going to pass the 7 to the side pocket the one ball. He's doing your shot. I think he's jacking up a little bit and come underneath the 8. And send it 3 wells to the 2. Here's
there he
both.
Is. Wow.
He's got a kill.
Now,
he's got a kill.
There's 2, but wow.
He's banking good, ain't he?
Yeah.
I saw an Accu-Stat tape of him in the finals in San Marino one time. He made 3 banks in a row against Bustamante. Like a long row bank, and then
really?
He had to play for banks 3 in a row, and he met them all. It was a bank layout.
Did he have safe options, or did he just?
He could have, but they were pretty natural banks.
Oh, yeah,
really?
Yeah.
Now this is side pocket is awfully bank. He's got to really slow roll this to not. That was it.
Oh,
you see what I mean?
Wow, he was more.
He was so scared to scratch that he hit the 2 full in order to make sure that he's not going to scratch.
That's right.
So subconsciously, your brain doesn't want to scratch, and it makes you hit the 2 ball where you really don't want to hit it. Here.
He's like, my brain cheated me. That's what he's thinking right now. I got cheated by my own brain. But, nevertheless, you got Will Murder. Look, Max. Man, I admire how Max, how composed he can, he stays, man, in matches. It's unbelievable. He won't show any anger, yeah, any frustration.
You're right, he really
just
doesn't.
Just rarely, you know? He's gonna try and hit this fool in the face. Make the cue. It's gotta come up. It's gonna come up. Well, that's the most he could do, really. That's a pretty good shot, because he had to bend into the cue ball to create the angle around the four,
right,
to kick at it, to kick the two straight in the face. So he couldn't put any speed on it. You know what I mean? So that's the most he could do with it. Put it on the rail. It was a pretty good shot for what he had.
You ever go with another bank?
Yeah, I think so. He's gonna go all the way up table. Look at this.
No, he's all right.
Nice shot. Man, Johnny Max, good. And the five passes to eight. So he set himself up for a good out here. Here we see a nice picture of his fundamentals. Johnny has a little wrist snap in his struggle. I mean, he's got a loose wrist and then like snaps it in. Coming out for close to the center of the table again. He's got a nice angle to go towards the seven now. Nine ball's all about angles, anyway. So keep your angles, you don't really have to do much a lot of times. Let's play smart. Nice angle on the seven, and now he's perfect on eight. Just draw down. Nice. So Johnny missed the two ball, got lucky.
Yeah.
And Johnny banked a couple of really good shots in there.
He makes it 9-6. Johnny Archer over Max Everly, 9-6, race to 11. I'll tell you what, ever since he came, he took a game from Max, and then he went to break. He went for a break. That's when we took the break. Here we are, 9-6.
Yeah, but he took a break on 6-4.
Yeah.
Max, 6-4 up. Broke, ran out. And he just made a couple of really good shots. He made that jacked up shot in the two after Max didn't get out, that really crucial wreck. Then he made two banks in this game.
Yeah.
So he's been doing a lot of shot making. Here you see the two ball right behind the one.
Now he didn't put the three. He didn't put the. Usually you see a 1-2-3, 1-2-4.
You know why not? Because if you would be break from the side, the chances that you make a ball are much higher. So then you go all out for those two balls to go up table. Now with the box, there's still a percentage that you're not going to make a ball in the break. So if you don't, the other guy gets that layout. So
sure,
you're like,
sure,
you're taking, put the two there, but not all three balls. You know what I mean? Because then it's like Mickey Mouse almost.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That you're going to sell out. Squatted him, but two ball. Look at this.
Wow.
Max is not going to be liking this. It's pretty straight in, though. He's making sure he's got enough chalk on his tip.
So what's he going to do? Draw it straight back to the rail?
Yeah, he's going to draw it back with left-hand English. Three. Let the spin do the work. There you see it. Nice shot.
He'll put the three and the four in the same corner.
Yep. Playing with a little bit of inside English. Right English. Got a little straight in. That's what I was just saying.
thinking, like, what side of the floor is he going to play on?
Yeah, I think you want to put a little more spin on that cue ball. I think you want to be where you're
playing. More on the right side of
yeah.
On the right side of this. Oh, he's still got a little. This, you know?
That's one thing I like is that he took what it was willing to give him as opposed to try something risky.
Yeah.
With that, you know, from the 4 to the 5.
Yeah, that's a good tip. Sometimes if you're in a tough spot, but you know you're going to get a shot afterwards, but it's not going to be as good as you thought.
Right.
Just take that shot.
Take what the table's going to give you and deal with it. You know, as opposed to stress out, try and make something, and you end up making a mistake.
End up losing it. He's going with the high English. No, it's so deceiving, man. What's going on? The way he was lining up, it looked like he was hitting it with a lot high. Now, I can predict this one. Just draw it with right in English. Two reels. Long reel, long reel. Come out one reel for the same pocket on the nine.
I believe he's going to be on the hill, right?
Yeah, Johnny's been playing good. The way he's playing, he might be favored for the title.
He's going to be waiting for either Parita
or Santos.
10-6, Johnny Archer with the break. Things changed. It was at 6-3 with Max in the lead.
Yeah, he's lost 7 straight. 10-6. It's not like he played a bad match.
No.
Johnny's just been taking it out of his hands.
You're right. Got lucky when he missed the, what was it, the 2?
He missed the 2 where he had to flirt with side pocket.
And he got a.
And he hooked him.
He got a good roll.
Max didn't get out that crucial time to make it, what was the score there? To make it, I think, 8-7. 7-6 or 7-7. Hey, Johnny's playing with a new cue, isn't he? I haven't seen that one yet. I think he just got that.
Johnny Spark, sponsored by Scorpion Cues.
Yeah.
That's the cue that he uses.
I've seen that breaker a long time, but that cue he's playing with now. We'll ask him in a minute when we do the interview with both guys. I know he's going to whack these. This is going to be his last break, no matter what.
Now, will we be interviewing both of them or just the winner?
I'm not sure. Me and Johnny had an interview last night, the two of us, after our match. So.
Oh, okay.
We'll see what happens. He's going to lay everything he has in that break.
Look at this.
Nice
look,
break,
at the one, look at the one going towards the
way he's
there.
Breaking. He's going to be tough to beat, I'll tell you.
I don't see any real problems here.
Just the 1 to the 2. He's got to go in between. He could play for the corner and just play a stop shot on the 4 or on the 2, and he's got the 4 straight in for the corner. Or he's got to go in between some traffic and play for the side pocket.
Yeah.
I like to just play for the corner actually, because I know I don't have to go in between balls. Because how's he going to get to the 2? He's got to go.
Well, how about coming between the 4 and the 8 here at this angle here?
Yeah, but that's risky because if you hit, I mean, yeah, I'll bet you he's just playing for the corner. Right there. He doesn't have to do anything, really. Just make the positions automatic. He got a little beyond straight in, though. That's the only thing he didn't like. He wanted to be on.
This is the exact same.
The other side? Yeah. Hit that one good. Yeah. What I would do here is just play a stop shot, or just make sure I can see it.
I don't know if a stop shot will do it. Maybe it will.
Is he hooked by
the? Well, see, there's the 5 here, right?
Well, at least the angle like in between the 6 and 9, because then I got a natural angle to go towards the 6 after I make the 5. Oh, man. I don't know if that's what he wanted
to do. Well, he had to do something. I don't think he could have stopped it because I think that nine was in the way.
Right. He hit it real first. Created a little more angle off that rail. Smart shot. As opposed to just hitting the ball first.
Yeah.
And you have to play more position. If you hit the rail first, you create more angle after you hit the ball. So it comes into that sweet two-rail pattern towards the six. Now, what do you like here? You like to just go one rail or two rails today with inside or just one rail?
Me, I'm going to go one.
One rail.
Oh, he goes,
he
two.
Goes to the other corner.
Oh, wow.
He had us both fooled there. He'll just draw this out right in
this game. I'll be buying this DVD.
That's a good one. Just draw it. Right hand English. Nice stroke on it. Boom.
Here we go.
He's the favorite in my book to go all out. He's playing good. Man,
there we go. That's 11-6, Johnny Arch over Max Eberle. A good match.
Great match.
Max had him 6-3, 1 point. And that was it.
Yeah, I never got going
after
that.
Yeah.
6-3. Okay, we're going to have an interview with Johnny. He'll be over here in a minute. Yeah, like you said, 6-3. And really, Johnny just took it right out of his hands. He made three incredible banks. He made that jacked up shot in the two. He started breaking like a champion. He ran three and out.
Yeah.
And Max just didn't get out one time. That was it.
Well, he made it 4-6, took that break. Remember, he took that break, comes back. He breaks the balls, gets a perfect break, gets out, and then that was it.
Yeah. We'll see what he has to say about it himself in a minute.
He's going
to
be joining us here in the booth at any moment. Putting stuff together.
He's getting stuff.
I believe the next matchup is going to be Jose Perica versus Santos.
Sambojan.
Sambojan.
Sambojan, Sambojan.
I've heard it a couple different ways.
Filipinos, always good.
It's going to be, definitely going to be a great match. Johnny's making his way to the booth now.
All right, he's coming over. We're just making sure. All right, he'll be walking in a minute here. And I guess you guys can just stay tuned for the next match, right? On the internet. If you bought the All Day Pass, you just grab yourself something out of the fridge and be back in action for some more.
We're going to be here with Johnny Archer in a moment.
We're getting Mr. Max Eberle first.
Mad Max Eberle.
Mad
Max.
Mr.
Hey, dude. What's going on? Have a seat, buddy. We're live. I feel a little bad for you there.
Feel sorry for me?
No, not. It's not sorry. You played a pretty good match, but Johnny just took it right out of your hands, I feel.
Well, I missed the safety on the one trying to get behind the eight when I was up 6-3.
Yeah.
I missed that. That put him back in the match. And then I missed one earlier. I missed a couple safeties in the match.
Yeah.
Which cost me like 6 or 7 games. And then when he was up 7-6, he left me the one ball, and I got a little funny on the two.
Yeah, and you played for the three with the eight?
I made the three.
Got off the eight, right?
Well, I got bad on the three.
Yeah.
And that was but I was just I just need to be a little bit more mentally with my process, because I left out the step of picking the exact spot where the cue ball goes. I just was trying to make the ball and figure out how to position.
Do you think you're getting out anyway?
Yeah, but normally I'm always going to pick the exact spot.
Exactly.
And because I didn't do that, I deserve to lose. Yeah,
because I was thinking of that as soon as the layout. I pointed out to Frank, I said the most important thing with this layout is getting from the 3 to the 4, and you don't want to mess with the 8.
Yeah.
And the first thing you did is put it on the side where you have to mess with the 8.
Right,
so
that
caused a problem right there. He missed the 4.
Yeah.
But Johnny, he just made a couple of great bank shots. He made like 3 to 4 banks, and he made that jacked up shot on the 2.
Right.
And so, I mean, he played a great match.
Yeah, he did play a great match. It's just, you know, you can't give him those opportunities.
No.
You know, but I did.
I feel he played a great tournament, though. Every time I played, you were in the arena fighting for your life. I mean, you had a couple of hill-hill matches.
Yeah.
But I had a lot of respect for your fighting spirit in this tournament. And,
thanks, man.
Just good showing, really.
Thank you.
Viewers, tell us what was going on with the rack. You guys were tapping it in there.
Oh, he made the 9 ball to go up 2-1, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, he made the 9 ball, and he said he made it because the ball back there wasn't frozen to the 9. So actually that was very sportsmanlike of him, because he could have kept breaking from there, making the 9, but also I could have been making it too, so it was actually smart to start tapping the ball in, because it would prevent me from making the 9
gets
also.
Gets more play in the game.
That's one thing we did appreciate, because we noted that both of you are on the cruise committee for the UPA.
Right, right.
Right.
That's why you're on the cruise committee for the UPA, because you have great ethics with the cruise committee. So we appreciate that.
Cool.
Thank you.
Alrighty, well, anyway, really, once again, great performance.
Thanks, and you too. You had a great tournament, Niels.
And Frank?
Fun.
Yeah.
I saw you shooting.
We're going to be talking
too,
to Johnny.
Making some nice runouts.
You can switch the mic over to Johnny.
Thanks a lot.
Hold on one second.
Hello, everybody. Have a great day.
Yeah. Alrighty. Yeah, Max is won 8 in a row, really. He lost his very first match, 8 in a row, and then he lost this one. All right, we're here with Mr. Archer. What's going on, my man?
What's up, buddy?
Good shooting.
Thanks.
We watched the whole match, me and Frank, and you were down 6-3. It started out, it looked like you guys were a little nervous in the beginning. There was a little bit of tension, but then you started coming out with all kinds of shots. You took that break, the restroom break, you got back, made it... You start breaking a lot better, and you made some great banks. That was, in my book, what won you the match, your shot making.
Yeah, I was a little bit tense, and I kind of had been, you know, me and my wife had made a deal that I wasn't going to get down on myself, you know, and let that cost me the match. And I made a couple mistakes early. I missed a combination, and I made a stupid position play when I ended up getting straight on the long four.
On the four, yeah. For this,
it was a couple balls in the way, and if I tried to play it for the side, I could get snookered.
Right.
You know, there's a couple different ways to get
snookered. Yeah, we saw that. Yeah.
So I said, you know what? The pockets are fairly big, and I said, if I just hold the angle here on the four, I can just shoot it rolled out.
Right.
And the pocket's this big.
You got straight
And I'm playing pretty good. And when I hit it, it came off the rail a lot further than I thought. And I actually hit the ball fat, too, like I wanted to.
Right.
You know, I said I'd hit a little fatter to make sure it don't come off. And then when it, you know, once I get there, I'm dead. And it looks stupid, but I mean, a quarter inch the other way, and I can just roll up.
Right.
But, you know, and then I missed the ball. And I kind of got to thinking, and, you know, whenever you do, anytime you make a decision like that and it don't work out, you always second-guess yourself.
Right,
I mean, everything's perfect if it works out fine. But then if you make a mistake, you second-guess yourself. And I started doing that, and then he gave me an opportunity at 6-3, and I won that game. And I said, you know what, let's take a break, watch my face, and just get back into, you know, I'm only a couple games down with the break.
Yeah, you started breaking a lot better.
And I started getting shots and started breaking the balls better. I made a couple good long shots
You made that jacked up shot in the 2 with the left English. That was a really good shot. But in my book, you made like 3 or 4 banks.
I made two or three banks
positions.
In the side, and had to get good position on the balls.
And you made the bank in the corner off the 5. You had to come all the way. You almost scratched, but you got good position there.
Yeah.
You made like 4 banks. But how did that? Where you grew up? Is that you played a lot of bank pool there? Or?
Not really. I was a math major in school.
Yeah.
When I was in school, I was pretty much, I was one of the honor roll students in the math. I think it was the only subject that I passed. But that and PE and lunch. But But yeah, I was a very, very, you know, I'm good with numbers,
okay.
Good with angles. I'm very, very good with. I can see them very well.
You've got talent for
and,
it.
You know, and it's just something God gave me, okay. You know, and I used that to my bank, you know, banking, kicking. I could get a little bit better with kicking.
Right.
I know I can, but banking, it just seems like, you know, banking's straightforward anyway. Kicking, you have to hold the ball,
right.
Spin the ball in off the record.
You're hitting
a cue ball. You know, whereas banking the balls is pretty much, you know, 90 degree angles. You can.
It's right
them
in
out.
Front of your face.
It's right there.
Right.
You just hit the ball, and you know, and so that's you know, I'm when I'm playing well, I think well.
Yeah.
When I'm playing well, I see them very
feel
well.
Them.
I can feel them, and I
right.
see them very well, and I don't mind shooting at a bank shot.
It's good. It's a good game to practice because I remember the one time you came over to Europe in Portugal. Where we played the Euro Tour,
yeah.
I asked you to play, explain me how to play bank pool.
Right.
And this was like 3-4 years ago.
Right.
And you showed me all this, and they showed me some rules, and then we started playing a little bank pool,
right.
So everybody got a little better at
got
it.
Got
back home,
into the back bank pool.
So
yeah.
That's a really good game to practice for people back home.
Well, the thing about it is, you know, when you get a bank shot, you know, a lot of people think, okay, well, should I bank at this ball or should I play safe?
Right.
You know, there's only two options. But the thing about it is, if a bank shot is like shooting a ball straight in,
right.
If you know how to bank the ball in.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like shooting at a ball. Because, you know, there's a lot of bank shots I'd rather have than a lot of straight
right,
shots.
Yeah.
You know, I'd rather, and there's a lot of the American players grew up playing it.
Right.
You know, Nick Varner's one of the best I've ever seen
at
banking the ball. Buddy Hall.
Shannon Dalton.
There's a few guys, if you leave them a bank shot, I'd rather leave them 6-8 foot long. Straight.
Right, right.
You know, I'd rather leave them that for
right.
sure than a bank shot. But, you know, and we all kind of grew up. I grew up playing the nine ball bank, you know, just getting bank shots playing nine ball. I grew up that way.
Okay.
You know, I played a little banks, but not a whole lot. But,
okay.
You know, it's fun, and I enjoy it, and hopefully I can keep playing.
All right, Johnny. Well, that wraps it up for today. I'm going to congratulate you again. Great performance. If you keep playing like this, I think you're going to snap it off.